Hello, tech enthusiasts. Today, we're going on a journey to discover the unsung hero of your Dyson V11 vacuum cleaner, the motor circuit board. If your vacuum suddenly stopped, or if you're noticing a drop in performance, don't miss this video. Because here, we will unveil the secrets of the repair process and show you how the components work. You'll get all the tips you need to revive your vacuum, and you might even be able to make your own repairs without needing a professional. If you're ready, let's start this exciting journey. You can also share any questions or comments you have below. The motor and electronic circuit board of the Dyson V11 vacuum are designed to optimize the vacuum's performance. This board controls the motor and manages power consumption. Let's examine the functions of the components on this circuit board and the principles of how the board operates under a microscope. We begin by showing the connection points on the circuit board. These terminals, you see, are the connection points for the electric motor. These terminals are the battery connection points. The connection points in the corners belong to the brush motor. This socket is for the LCD screen, and the other socket is for the button. There are three capacitors on the circuit board. These capacitors help balance the instantaneous power fluctuations that the motor needs, ensuring more stable operation. Capacitors can fail for various reasons, leading to motor malfunctions. Let's take a closer look at the circuit board and its components under the microscope. There are four MOSFETs on the circuit board. The MOSFETs with part number T4-8504, PEL-1 control the speed and torque of the motor. MOSFETs regulate the operation of the motor by turning the electric current on and off. This way, the device's performance and energy efficiency are enhanced. Additionally, MOSFETs perform the speed adjustment function of the motor, allowing the vacuum to work effectively on different surfaces. If your vacuum motor isn't running at all, I recommend checking the MOSFETs first. If your MOSFETs are faulty, make sure to check the current limiting resistors connected to the gate terminals of the MOSFETs. The SM'd resistor with code R001 has a value of 1 milliamp. The function of this resistor is to monitor the motor current. This way, in cases of excessive current, the protection circuit under processor control activates to prevent damage to the motor and other components. In summary, the R001 resistor plays a significant role in safety and performance. The Hall effect sensor is used to determine the rotational speed of the motor. The Hall effect sensor provides feedback to the motor driver. This information helps control the motor accurately and adjust its speed. Additionally, it works in coordination with the R001 resistor in overload situations to activate protection mechanisms. The U2 integrated circuit is a voltage regulator IC. It supplies the necessary operating voltage for the microcontroller. The U1 integrated circuit is the microcontroller. With part number at SAMP21E18AU, This microcontroller is the brain of the Dyson V11 vacuum cleaner. Motor control, processing sensor data, battery management, user interface, and error management are all facilitated by this microcontroller. The U8 and U9 integrated circuits located on the back of the board are driver ICs that control the motor driver MOSFETs. This driver IC, with part number ELM5109B, controls the MOSFETs based on signals received from the microcontroller, enabling the electric motor to operate. If you detect any faults in your MOSFETs, you should definitely check these integrated circuits as well. This diode, you see, is connected to the brush motor power line and protects against reverse voltages that may come from the brush motor. The MOSFET with part number NVFS5811NL controls the electricity going to the brush motor. When we command the brush motor, this MOSFET sends the electric current to the circuit board on the brush motor. The resistor with code R005 has a value of 5 milliamp. The function of this resistor is to protect the brush motor from excessive current draws. In our video, we thoroughly examined the components of the motor control board of the Dyson V11 vacuum and the principles of how this board works. The motor control board is a critical component that ensures the vacuum operates efficiently and effectively. Examining the functions of the components on the motor control board provided us with important information while repairing the Dyson V11. Knowing this information will make troubleshooting and repairs easier. If you like this video, don't forget to like it and subscribe to my channel. You can also share any questions or comments you have below. See you in the next video. Take care.